There is confusion in the skies as air travel starts to pick up. With mixed guidelines from the airlines and no federal rules, travelers are not sure what to do when it comes to social distancing. CBS 2's Christina Fan reports.
So I'm on this flight and it is really full.
Sarah Lewitton, dressed head to toe in a homemade garbage bag gown, showed us her packed flight from JFK to LAX this week. She says she taped together this extreme but necessary outfit to protect herself after seeing concerning photos of overcrowded planes.
But as soon as it was time to get off the plane, I was really disturbed by how much of like a cattle call situation it was.
U.S. Airlines have drawn a lot of criticism in recent weeks over confusing social distancing guidelines. There is no government standard. While an internal memo from Southwest Airlines obtained by CNN instructs crew members not to stop passengers from boarding if they refuse to wear a mask, JetBlue CEO has taken the opposite approach.
We're asking all of our customers to wear masks because, you know, when you're in an airline seat, even if you're keeping the middle seat free, you're not going to be 6 feet away from someone.
When it comes to those middle seats, some airlines went back on their word after pledging to block them out. Travel editor Peter Greenberg is not surprised. He says keeping the center seat open is just not financially feasible.
Their entire business model is predicated on filling all those seats. And if they didn't, the cost of your airline ticket would go up between $80 and $300 a flight.
For now, packed flights are the exception. But as travel picks back up, passengers are hoping there's some sort of standardization of social distancing rules.
I don't know if airlines are really practicing that as much as they should.
Experts say the industry has made several changes to lower possible exposure, from changing boarding practices to getting rid of paper boarding passes. Christina Fan, CBS 2 News.